During a meeting by environmental activists and leaders from the West Nile at Letsuba Hotel in Arua City, it was discovered that there are various activities that have contributed to climate change in the West Nile region. The leaders decided to debate over a number of issues on how they can end destruction of the environment, starting with their region. Illegal cutting down of trees has been cited as one of the major contributors to climate change in the West Nile in the recent survey unveiled by Twaweza East Africa on people's attitudes to climate change in the country.
What was given was cutting down of trees, and that was given by 62%. Then we see 23% who say that it is a natural phenomenon, that it's bound to happen anyway. Then we see 15% saying that it's because of farming or the different agricultural practices that we undertake in our communities. Then others, 9%, say it's God's punishment. Yes. Then 3% say it's pollution. In a way, we were kind of surprised also to see that 3%, because most times when you hear about climate change, it's talking about the carbon emissions in the developed countries because they are highly industrialized. But we do have some Ugandans that are talking about pollution.
In a heated debate about the matter with regional leaders, it was put clear that signs of a desert climate have already arrived.
When you talk about weather, primitively, we are seeing danger, but we cannot do much. We want people like you to come up, because now our Uganda here is based on I. We has gone away. How do you individually do much for yourself and your country?
They claim so little can be done locally to curb the situation, as big shots in government are cited as key players in the vice.
I was informed on this in Arua City. I had to drive there. I disarmed three people who were armed to threaten people. And that is the kind of scenario we are having in West Nile. That is just one case out of several of them. These kind of actions are happening on Mount Kei, on Mount Midiko, on Mount Wati, on Mount Luku, all these places, because these tree species exist there. This is unacceptable.
The deputy RDC of Arua says there is need to set up ground rules and bylaws to tame the situation, pointing out loopholes in the existent prohibitive law. He urges government to subsidize more on alternative sources of energy like gas to make it more affordable.
Let the district local governments have ordinance by law to restrict cutting of the trees locally here. Because that the bigger law we have has issues. But at the district level, let us have some by law to regulate usage of our environment. Then the DPCs can enforce, the RDC can say, please let us enforce this bylaw at the district. When these people come with their vehicles, if I have such a bylaw, I can say, please, this truck will not go. That big person of yours, we want to see him. That one can happen.
As Cedric Fred, the Arua City Environment Officer, appealed for heavier funding for environmentally friendly activities.
Well, what my colleague from Koboko mentioned is what is happening in most local governments. We in the local governments, we have the plans, we have the policies, the policy on climate change, we have it. We have the regulations to enforce some of these things. But the major challenge of the local government is funding for the activities. The local governments cannot organize this kind of function to send a message to the people. That is the major problem.
Activists have highlighted that global climate change illiteracy is a general problem throughout the world. They say numerous other countries' studies also point to the same tendency. They have pointed out that many people believe that climate change is a myth, hoax or conspiracy. They've urged environmentalists to focus on mindset change if they're to fight climate change. Report compiled by Dennis Chobe for the news.